السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. ویلکم ٹو وزڈم انٹرنیشنل اسکولز ڈیجیٹل کلاس روم. ٹوڈے وی آر گوئنگ ٹو لرن اے اسمال ٹاپک فرام چیپٹر ٹرائنگلز بیسک پروپورشنالٹی تھیورم. اٹس آلسو کالڈ ایز تھیلز تھیورم. بیسک پروپورشنالٹی تھیورم, دس از اے تھیورم ویئر یو ہیو ٹو گیو دا اسٹیٹمنٹ پلس دا پروونگ. بوتھ آر آسکڈ ان یور ایگزام, ان یور بورڈ ایگزام. So this may be asked for 4 or 5 marks. That is, the question will go like this: state and prove basic proportionality theorem or Thales theorem. Okay, so Thales theorem, the statement goes like this. Thales theorem: if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle intersecting the other two sides in distinct points, then the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Have a triangle ABC, and if I draw a line DE parallel to side BC, for example, okay, then the other two sides, that is the side AB and AC, will be divided in the same ratio. The same ratio in the sense AD divided by DB will be equals to AE divided by EC. So that is what your Thales theorem states. So if I draw a triangle, and in that triangle if I draw a line parallel to any one of the sides of the triangle, then the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. So first, whenever they ask you to state and prove a theorem, you're supposed to memorize the statement, write down the theorem statement, and then you first write down what is given. Okay, so the given thing is that this is a triangle ABC, and in this triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. So that is the only thing which is given to us. And we have to prove that AD over DB is equals to AE over EC. So this is the thing we are supposed to prove. So we write that also. Now, we can't just prove it with this thing alone. So we do a small construction, and this construction is, we have to make two constructions over here. One is, we just join BE and DC. Okay, so you get two triangles over here. One is BDE and the other one is DCE. Okay, and then the second construction, what you need to do is, here you will draw a line ME perpendicular to AD or AB, and another line DN perpendicular to BC. So these are the two constructions. We are doing it on our own so that, you know, we are able to proceed with the proving statement. Okay, now the proof. Now coming to the real proof. So we already know that area of a triangle is half base times height. This we have learnt in our junior classes. So we are going to use this formula to solve this theorem. So if you talk about this triangle ADE, that is the small triangle on top, so you have to keep following the figure as we proceed with the statements and the as we proceed with the proving. So in triangle ADE, this little triangle on top, you can see that AD could be considered as base. If we take AD as the base, then EM turns out to be our height. So area of triangle ADE can be written as half base times height. So half base could be taken as AD and height could be taken as EM. Now if you consider a triangle BDE, so this is an obtuse triangle. BDE is an obtuse triangle, and the height for BDE is also EM. Since it's an obtuse triangle, the height lies outside the triangle, right? So this is a height for the triangle BDE also, and BDE, in this triangle BDE, this BD is the base. So if you use the same area of a triangle formula, we get area of triangle BDE is equals to half DB, that is the base, into EM. EM is your height. So now we have got two equations, two formulas for two different triangles. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to just divide 1 by 2. So if I divide the equation 1 by equation 2, I get area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE. So that's going to be, area of triangle ADE is half into AD into EM. That the whole thing is divided by half into DB into EM. Now you see, the half and half gets cancelled, the EM and EM gets cancelled, and you get the answer as AD divided by DB. So if you, the area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE is equals to AD divided by DB. Now this we will keep it as A. Okay, now you see the thing, if you go and look at the to prove statement, we are supposed to prove that AD by DB is equals to AE by EC. So now we have got AD by DB. Now we have to see what is our AE by EC. So for that, we will do another small proving. So we come to this side. So take a triangle ADE again, the little triangle on top. And here now we will consider AE as the base. So now if AE is the base, then DN turns out to be our height. Okay, so area of triangle ADE could also be written as half AE, which is the base, and DN, which is the height over here. Now let me take the next triangle, that is DEC. For DEC also, DN is the base, because DE is your obtuse triangle and obtuse triangle has a height lying outside. So DN turns out to be the height of this obtuse triangle DEC. So the area of triangle DEC is going to be written as half EC, which is the base, into DN, which is your height again. Now I'm going to divide these two equations. So equation 3 over 4. So area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle DEC is equals to half AE into DN divided by half EC into DN. So the whole thing as it is. Okay. Now I can cancel the halves over here and I can cancel the DNs. So we get AE divided by EC. Now this is your equation B. We have got two statements. Okay. Now we also know that earlier in our junior classes we have learned that if there are two triangles lying on the same base and they lie between two parallel lines, then the two triangles' areas are going to be equal. This we have already learnt in our 9th standard. So see, area of triangle, here triangle BDE and triangle DEC. So let's look at the figure. BDE and DEC, they both lie between the parallel lines DE and BC, and also they both have the same base DE, right? So then the area of triangle BDE and the triangle DEC are going to be equal. So using that, see now if you look at equation A and equation B, area of triangle ADE and area of triangle ADE on both the equations are there in the numerator, and in the denominators of both the equation we have got BDE in equation A and DEC in equation B. Now we know that since these two triangles lie in between the parallel lines and they lie on the same base, BDE's triangle's area and DEC's area are going to be equal. And in the numerator we already have the same triangle. So both A and B are going to be equal to each other. So area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE will be equals to area of triangle ADE by area of triangle DEC. So we already know that triangle ADE by BDE is going to give you AD by DB. That's by equation A. So I write AD by DB on this side. On the right side, area of triangle ADE by triangle DEC is going to be equals to AE by EC, which is actually by equation B. We can write AE by EC over here. So we get AD by DB is equals to AE by EC. See, so that you should not get confused how I got this, I have written it over here. From equation A and B I have got this. Okay, so this is what they have asked us to prove. So that's why I write hence proved. We have learned how to state and prove basic proportionality theorem. Now based on this theorem, they may give you problems, numerical problems based on this. So I have given you one example of this. If you have a triangle ABC, and see they have shown this DE and BC, and there are two arrows pointing on the same direction on DE and BC. This means that DE and BC are parallel to each other. So we know by basic proportionality theorem that if two sides are parallel to each other in a triangle, then the other two sides divide in equal ratio, right? So here by BPT, we can write that AD by DB is supposed to be equals to AE by EC. Now these things are given to us. AE is given as 2 cm, EC is given as 6 cm, and BD is given as 9 cm. They want you to find AD. Okay. So now we just have to write this equation, this ratio as per the basic proportionality theorem, and we will substitute the given values. AD we don't know, so I'll keep it as AD itself. DB is 9 cm, so I write 9 cm here. AE is 2 cm, so write 2 over here. And EC is 6 cm, so write 6 over here. Now I need to find the AD. I don't want the 9 over here, so I need to move the 9 to the other side. So since it's divided by AD, when it moves to the other side, it gets multiplied. So you get 2 by 6 into 9. So 2 times 9 is 18 divided by 6, which is 3 centimeter. So we get AD is equals to 3 centimeter. So this is a very small problem. Actually, we get only for one mark. Maybe it could be in your multiple choice question.